Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about pests of grainage and their management. Introduction. The success of sericulture mainly depends on the quality silkworm makes. Among many factors that affects egg production, the host of insect, that is dermated beetles, earwigs, ants, cockroaches, silverfish, caterpillars, soucids, etc., and non-insect pests like mites, lizards, rats, squirrels, birds, monkeys, etc., inflicts damage to different products in grainage, namely cocoons, pupae, moths, eggs, etc., and account significant loss and thus affects the economics of egg production. In this regard, detailed study on the pests of grainage and their management assumes greater significance for the production of superior quality of silkworm eggs. Insect pests. First one, that is dermated beetles. The dermated beetles belong to family Dermestidae of the order Coleoptera. The family contains about 400 species of small or moderate sized insects. Later, about 700 species of dermestids or skin beetles were described. Among these, 52 species of Dermestidae have recorded on varied stored product materials. So far, 30 species of dermestids are reported to be associated with sericulture industry world over. 24 species of dermestids have been reported from India and 6 species from Karnataka. Dermestid beetles, namely Dermestes aeter, Dermestes cadaverinis, Dermestes maculatus, Dermestes leechi, Atagenus fasciatus and Anthrenus verbasi, have been reported to attack the silkworm cocoons. Dermestes aeter. Dermestes aeter is a cosmopolitan pest attacking the dead birds and mammals, dried fish, leather goods, woolen clothes, copra, cheese, dried mushroom and silk. The larvae of Dermestes aeter are known to attack dried sea fish. The natural reservoirs of dermestid beetles are mainly the nests of bees, wasps, caterpillars, spiders, birds and rodents. Life cycle. The dermestid beetle Dermestes aeter is black in color and about 7 mm in length. The females lay about 150 to 200 eggs in the flowers of the cocoons. The incubation period is 3 to 6 days and the larval period lasts for 4 weeks with 5 to 7 instars. The pupal period is about 1 week. The life cycle in all takes about 6 weeks at 28 degrees centigrade. Damage. Dermestid beetles are known to attack the pierced cocoons in the cocoon storage rooms. These places serve as breeding centers for the beetles in grainages. The beetles from the pierced cocoon storage rooms migrate and damage the green cocoons and also inflict damage to the moths. Generally, the beetles attack the abdominal region of the moth. The damage level due to the beetle attack to the pupae as 16.62% and moth as 3.57%, with a total loss of 20.19% in government grainages of Karnataka. A study on the damage potential of different instars of dermestid beetles on silkworm cocoons revealed that the highest infestation of cocoons, that is 48%, was caused by the grubs of 7th instar, whereas 4th instar grubs inflicted lowest infestation, that is 20%. With the introduction of CSR biovolatile hybrids, the management of dermestid beetles in the silkworm seed production centers has become all the more important, as the seed cocoons are processed only after sexing the pupae. Dermestes cadaverinis. The damage is inflicted by grubs and bore through the cocoons, which are stored for a long time. The grubs bore through the cocoons and eat the pupae. In addition, the damage animal and plant products including leather, fur, dried fish, carpets, woolen and silk materials. The adult is oval, elongated, dark brown in color with club-shaped antennae and is about 1 cm in length. Generally, the insect overwintering in adult stage begins mating and starts laying eggs during May with a fecundity of 50 to 400 eggs in darker areas like crevices of dried organic matter, slits in the bamboo board or in the dust. The adult lives on an animal matter for nearly 1 year and after oviposition. Eggs are elongated, oval, 2 mm long and milky white. They hatch in a week, releasing the spindle-shaped grubs which are reddish-brown in color. The grubs feed on dried animal matter and after 5 to 7 months grows to a size of 15 mm length. Then they transform into pupae in about a week. Both the adults and grubs are attracted by the smell of cocoons and pupae. Make holes in the cocoons and feed on the pupal contents. The damaged cocoons become unfit for egg production. Dermestes maculatus. It infests cocoons on a small scale during December to October. The adults lay white elongate eggs singly or in groups of 2 to 5 on the silk floss. The egg is 0.84 to 0.92 mm. That is average is 0.89 in length and 0.50 mm width. The incubation period is 2.4 days. The grubs feed upon the dried pupae by making holes and cocoons, thus rendering them unfit for egg production. The grub consists of 6 to 9 instars, but 7 instars are very common. The full grown grub pupates inside the cocoon are on the surface of cocoon. Pupae are exerate, light yellowish, 6 to 7 mm in length and 3 to 3.5 mm in width. Pupal period lasts for 6 to 17 days. The adult beetle is comparatively bigger than carpet beetle, that is Atogenes fasciatus. The beetle measures 9.75 mm in length and 2.75 mm in width at the base of elytra. Adults are active in feeding upon the dried pupae, making it into small bits. The adults survive for 39.70 days. Dermestes lychee. It infests cocoons and the adult beetles lay yellow elongate eggs singly on the silk floss. The egg is 0.86 mm long and 0.49 mm wide. The incubation period occupies 3.5 days. The grub is bigger and active, bores deep into the cocoons and feeds upon the dried pupae inside. The infested cocoons become unfit for egg production. The full-grown grub pupates either inside or outside the cocoon. Pupae are exerate, light yellowish, 6.5 mm in length and 3.25 mm in width. Adult beetle is bigger but is uniformly black throughout, measuring 9.50 in length and 3.25 in width. The adult feeds upon the dried pupae. Atogenes fasciatus. The grubs and adults are attracted by the smell of the cocoons and pupae. The grubs make holes in the cocoons and feed on the dried pupae inside. All the larval instars damage the cocoons, shell, pupa and reed silk. The early 3 instars damage the cocoons by cutting the shell. But the grubs of 4th instar onwards feed directly boring into the cocoons, making characteristic circular holes. On securing the pupae, they feed more actively, transforming into the fine powder. When the grubs are provided with only cocoon shell, the grubs actively feed for 4 to 5 days and damage the shell but do not pupate. The grubs concentrate at the anterior and posterior ends of the pupa while feeding. Egg. Freshly laid egg is milky white and transparent. It is oval or elongate and smooth. A day before hatching, the egg turns brownish. The fully developed, tiny and delicate grub becomes out of the egg, breaking the chorion with the help of mandibles. Grub. In laboratory, the grub has 7 to 11 instars. However, 9 instars occur more commonly compared to 7, 8 and 10 instars. The freshly emerged grub is tiny, creamy white, elongate with light brown head bearing prominent brownish eyes. The grub is fusiform, tapering towards the posterior end. Pupa. Pupa is exudate, light yellowish and hairy. Abdominal segments are 9 out of which first 6 are clearly visible. Adult. The adult is compact, ovate, convex, block beetle with chestnut brown half moon shaped, making in the middle of elytra and club shaped antennae. However, male is smaller in size and chestnut brown half moon shaped marking is darker. Mating occurs during morning hours. The pre-mating period lasts for 2.3 days. Frequent mating at an interval of 2 minutes is observed. A single male mate with more than one female. The pre-oviposition and post-oviposition periods last for 12 and 6 days respectively. Eggs are laid during cooler hours of the day. The female prefers more fleshy cocoons in which the eggs are deeply thrusted. Oviposition period lasts for 8 days with maximum oviposition being on first day itself. The adults live for 32.2 days with food and 8.8 days without food. The fecundity is 141.3 eggs per female. Life cycle. The total life cycle from egg to adult and dried pupae of Bombyx mori varies from 137.25 to 142.00 days. During December to June, incubation period of 10 days, larval period of 110.53 days and pupal period of 13.06 days are encountered. Anthrenus verbasii. The larvae damage cocoons by boring holes in them. They damage raw silk and sometimes also feed on dry silkworm eggs. The adults' presence on plant material and their preference to daylight during their later part of the life cycle are the characteristics which distinguish them from members of the genus Dermestes. Eggs are 0.5 mm long, oval and milky white. The larvae are grayish brown, enlarged at the tail and have an elongated tumbler shaped body. The full grown larvae are about 3 to 4 mm long. Adult beetles are 2 to 3 mm in length, convex, slightly elongated and round with yellowish white scales on black background. The female lays 20 to 100 eggs on some living matter or dust. Eggs hatch in about 25 days. The larvae prefer dark places, feed on dry animal matter and molt 6 to 7 times by the end of summer. During later part of oviposition period, the adults fly to the daylight. They are often found on flowers in the nearby garden during May and July and leave for a month. Earwigs. The earwig Labia arachidis belongs to the order Dermaptera family Labidae. Is known to attack the moss in grainages. This species is cosmopolitan and exists in groups in almost every part of the world. It is predominant in tropical Asia. Its color varies to some extent in intensity and shade. Earwigs damage silk moss, especially gravid females, while ovipositing, thus affecting egg production. It is found hiding in the crevices of trays, walls, doors and windows and also in pierced cocoons. The female silk moss are attacked by adult earwigs in grainages. The nymphs do not attack the moss. At first, the earwigs hold the abdomen of moss with the help of mandibles and pinch the same with the aid of forceps like CERCI. A black scar develops on the mouth at the point of damage from which thick body fluid oozes out. Such damaged moths after mating lay less number of eggs and the eggs will be covered with black fluid. The ovipositing moths are also damaged in the similar way and many die in a lingering death. Further, earwigs also feed on the integument of attacked dead moths, especially from the abdominal region, but do not prefer the eggs inside. The loss due to earwigs to ovipositing moths is 15 to 20%. Eggs are laid in groups of 6 to 11. Whitish oval, soft and shining. The mother rests over the eggs and provides parental care. The egg period lasts for about 8 to 12 hours. The freshly emerged nymphs are milky white and active, turn to light brownish in about 30 minutes, stay in a group and are provided with parental care for 5 days. After 5 days, the nymphs disperse and live independently. The adult is medium size, dark brown and smooth, measuring 1.3 by 0.3 cm. The activity of labia arachidis was largely restricted to rainy season. Ants. Ants belongs to the order Hymenoptera family Formicidae. The ants cause significant loss to sericulturists by attacking the worms while rearing and mounting. Pupae, adults and eggs in grainages and cocoons in the market yards, reeling units and filatures. 14 species of ants are known to damage silkworms at different growth stages. Among the ant species, the fire ant, that is Solenopsis geminata, is considered as a serious species causing considerable damage to all stages of Bombyx mori. The damage stored cocoons by cutting the silk fiber, making walls of 3.50 to 3.65 mm and feeds on dead pupae. In general, the ant damage is less in cocoons with thick and compact shell. Monomorium feronis feed on pupae by cutting the cocoon shell and incur loss to grainage. Live pupae are more preferred by the ants than dried pupae. The forager of Solenopsis geminata equally prefers the eggs. Cockroaches. Cockroaches belongs to order Blattodea family Blattidae. Two species of cockroaches, namely Blattella germanica and Periplaneta americana, were found feeding on eggs of Bombyx mori in grainages throughout the year, but the extent of loss caused by cockroaches is negligible. Silverfish. Silverfish belongs to the order Thysanura family Lepismatidae. The extremely active diurnal omnivorous silverfish, Lepisma species, inhabiting the grainages throughout the year. Their exact role, apart from feeding on silk floss, could not be established. Caterpillars. Caterpillars belongs to the order Lepidoptera. Two species of Lepidopterans, such as Asura conferta, belongs to family Arctidae, and Tinea pelionella belongs to family Tenida, are found associated with pierced cocoons and cocoon floss respectively, and their activity was restricted from August to November in grainages. Socids. Socids belongs to the order Socoptera family Socidae. Minute soft-bodied apterous socids, Lipocillus transvalensis, were associated with egg sheet, that is 26.64%. Seed cocoons of NB4D2 22.22%. Spent moss 20.00%. Seed cocoons of pure Mysore 10.00%. And grainage sweepings 5.90%. Management strategies. Preventive measures. Storage of rejected cocoons and perished eggs for long period should be avoided. The cocoon storage rooms should be cleaned periodically. Before and after emergence of silk moths, the grainage premises should be cleaned. Provide a wire mesh to doors and windows in pierced cocoon storage rooms to avoid free movement of the beetles and grubs from pier's cocoon storage room to grainage operation room. Wooden articles of the storage room and grainage should be dipped in 0.2% melathion solution for 2 to 3 minutes. After 10 days, the trays should be thoroughly washed in water and sun-dried for 2 to 3 days before reusing. Control measures. Mechanical control. Collect the grubs and adults either by sweeping or by using a vacuum cleaner and destroy them by burning or dipping in soap water. Chemical control. Store pierced cocoons in deltamethrin treated bags, that is, soak the bags in 0.028% deltamethrin solution and dry in shade. Spray 0.028% deltamethrin solution on walls and floor of pierced cocoon storage room once in 3 months. Fumigation of pierced cocoon storage room with methyl bromide for a day or with chloropicrin for 3 days, that is 0.5 kg per 283 meter cube, could be very effective to control the incidence of dermestid beetles. Ethylene dibromide, that is EDB, at the rate of 3 milliliter per 0.1 meter cube provided 66.06% mortality, whereas at an exposure period of 72 hours, ethylene dibromide yields 90% mortality. Aluminium phosphide at the rate of 24 gram per meter cube at 24 hours exposure results in 90% mortality. Sprinkle bleaching powder at the rate of 200 gram per meter square all around inner wall of pierced cocoon room to prevent crawling of grubs from pierced cocoon storage room. Non-insect mites. Mites acari. Destroy each mite. Poyomotus pediculoides ventricosus belong to the order Acarina, family Poyomotidae, is encountered at the time of rethatching of roof of grainage building or is brought into the grainage building with building materials such as straw, wood or bamboo. Mites under 6 families, namely Acidae, Acaridae, Tarsonematidae, Tiadidae, Chelatidae, Rafignathidae, were found associated with seed cocoons, moths, egg sheets and sweepings in grainage. Among these unidentified species, the members of the families Acidae and Chelatidae were predominant species. Acidae mites were associated with spent moss, that is 31.66%, and egg sheets, that is 31.50%. During pairing, depairing, and oviposition, the moths flutter their wings, resulting in the dissemination of infested mites. The airborne mites, when inhaled, cause itching, irritation and possibly resulted in allergic symptoms among the persons involved in grainage activities. The Chelatidae mites were in large numbers associated with all sources of grainage. The mites and other families were seen in all grainage sources, but their role could not be ascertained. Lizards. The wall lizards are very common in grainages. The lizards attack live moss and preserved eggs and thus causing considerable damage. Rats. The rat species that attack different life stages of silkworm are Rattus rattus, Tatara indica, Mus musculus, Mus species and Bandicoota indica belongs to the order Rodentiae and family Muridae. Rats eat pupae inside the cocoons in grainages. During this process, the whole cocoon is damaged, which has to be discarded. Squirrels. The squirrel, Phenambulus palmarum, which belongs to the order Rodentiae and family Squirridae, was observed to feed on seed cocoons from grainage surrounded by vegetation throughout the year. They cut the seed cocoons with the incisors in a characteristic manner and feed on pupae, and such cocoons are unfit for egg production. Birds. The sparrows, Passer domesticus, belongs to the order Passeriformis and family Passeridae, were closely associated with grainages, causing substantial loss by picking and feeding on the emerged, paired and ovipositing moths. Monkeys. The monkeys, Macaca radiata, belongs to order primates and family Cercopithecidae, were noticed damaging the seed cocoons in grainages. The monkeys pick the seed cocoons during sorting and from seed cocoon storage room they are found to bite the cocoons and feed on pupae. Management strategies. In grainages, flooring should be done by reinforced cement concrete, that is RCC, or stone slabs as far as possible to avoid rat problem. During construction of grainage building, due importance should be given to build rat-proof structures such as suitable ledge. The vicinity of the grainage should be made rat-free by avoiding garbage dumping around which harbors the rats. Cleanliness has to be maintained in grainage and dumping of materials inside grainage should be avoided. Natural enemies such as cats can be encouraged. Direct catching and killing of rats should be adopted wherever possible so that multiplication can be brought down. Trapping the rats by using different types of rat traps with suitable bait material also helps to control rats. The rat population remains at the lowest level during summer due to less breeding and non-availability of natural food. With zinc, phosphate or use of anticoagulants, poison baits can be successfully employed with due precautions at such times so as to effectively reduce the population. Catching and killing of lizards is effective in reducing the loss due to lizards. Strict vigilance should be kept on all the non-insect pests, especially squirrels, birds, monkeys, as they are sufficiently destructive. Wire mesh should be provided for windows so as to effectively block their entry. The study provides the detailed information on both insect and non-insect pests affecting the quality and quantity of silkworm egg production in grainages along with management strategies for the containment of these pests.